Are you an e-learning professional who wants to make screencasts for training courses? Or are you going to start your vlog on YouTube and show how to use specific software? In this video, I will explain how to screencast and what to consider before recording, so keep on watching. Happy Thursday, everyone! I'm Paulina, and today is another great day to learn something new. So let's get started. Before we dive deep, let's explain what exactly a screencast is. A screencast is a video recording that captures the actions that take place on the screen. You can also often hear people calling it a screen capture video or a screen recording. A screencast can contain various objects like text, images, audio, and even mouse movements. A screencast is a type of video tutorial that is most often created to demonstrate a process that's shown on the screen. But although such videos are all instructional, they can be used for different purposes by different people. Here is who can benefit from screencasting. First of all, it's learning and development professionals. With screencasts, learning pros can demonstrate to their employees how to use the software they need to carry out their job duties. For example, create a video guide to Microsoft Excel or record an LMS walkthrough. The second audience is teachers. Screencasting helps teachers save more time on introducing the topic in the classroom and invest more time in practice and discussions. This approach is referred to as a flipped classroom. For instance, a teacher can record their screen while explaining how to solve math equations and share the video with the students, so they can watch it before coming to class. Another group is software development companies. Organizations that produce software or often a web service can benefit greatly from making video tutorials on how to use their tools. This is where screencast can come into play again. The next audience is YouTube instructors. Skillful Photoshoppers, advanced users of Microsoft Excel, and other software experts use screencasts to share their knowledge with the world. And the last group is gamers. For gamers, a screencast is a way to share their gameplay with the world, as well as get feedback on their skills and teach their peers how to improve their performance. Whether you're making a screencast for a classroom, an online course, or a YouTube video, here is how you do it, step by step. Step number one, make a plan and write a script. You have only 10 seconds to capture and engage an audience. From the very beginning of the video, they should understand that this screencast is what they need now. To captivate your viewers right away, plan your video. Decide where to start, what to show in the middle, and how to end. Then prepare a script. Don't skip this step, as the script will help you make your screencast more concise, think about some talking points and tips that will make the lesson more useful, figure out what you should show and when, avoid unnecessary pauses while recording, reduce the time for video editing, and reduce any unnecessary stress. Writing a script is actually quite easy. In an instructional video, the first few moments should draw the viewer in and give them reason to watch what you have to present. Don't use the first 5 seconds of your video to tell people your company name. Use them to share why they should keep watching. This can be done with a dialogue or graphics. You can start with a statement about the goal and provide a plan of your tutorial so a viewer can see what to expect right away. In the middle of the screencast, you need to describe the topic in as much detail as needed to transfer the knowledge required to solve the issue. At the end, you can give a summary and go through the key points once again if your video is long. If it is short and focused on one topic, repetition may not add value. You may also want to give the viewer an action they can perform. This also helps to further anchor the learning. For example, if your video is about creating a new PowerPoint template rather than recapping the steps, invite viewers to actually do it. If you're worried about the viewer remembering the steps, it's probably better to provide a job aid or handout that's easy to open in another window, download, or print. At the very end, give a preview of the next lesson. Write the script in a conversational tone, without complex phrases or a lot of acronyms and jargon. It's okay to use contractions, even slang. Keep your audience in mind. Using more informal language will make your video easier to understand and hopefully put your viewers at ease with the presenter. To make sure the text works, read it out loud. This will help you notice complex phrases or awkward transitions. Are there places in the script that don't sound natural? If so, make the necessary touch-ups. You can also check the text for readability in Hemingway. This online editing tool will help you find complex sentences and phrases, excessive adverbs, and passive voice constructions that you can turn into an active voice. You will find the link to the service in the description. When writing your script, make sure that you choose words that have a purpose. Make each word fight for its place in the script. If the word isn't helping the viewer to understand or move towards the purpose of the video, consider cutting it. Step number 2. Choose a microphone. A headset or a built-in laptop microphone are bad tools for voice acting. Ambient background noises such as hissing, crackling, or echoing may appear in the recording. Use a separate microphone for making screencasts. First, define the type of device you need. There are dynamic mics. They block out room echo and background noise as well. Most often, they are used by musicians at concerts where there is no time for sound processing. And there are condenser mics, which, to the contrary, catch even the ticking of a clock. But if you record your voice in complete silence, you can achieve a decent sound using this type of device. Condenser mics are most often used at radio stations. Another important consideration is how it will be connected to your computer. XLR mics are of high sound quality, but they are connected to a computer via an external sound card or a special adapter. You need to buy it separately. USB mics can be plugged into an available USB port on the computer. It's much easier, however, the sound quality is sometimes worse than of XLR devices. There are also some useful microphone accessories that can help achieve a pure sound, even if you are recording a voice on the street or in an apartment next to a construction site. A microphone isolation shield partially mutes extra sounds in the room and filters out the echo. As a rule, it's placed behind the microphone. A pop filter suppresses breathing noises, softens sibilant S and SH sounds, and blocks plosives like P, B, and T, which can max out the decibels and sometimes cause signal clipping. You will find a list of microphones, a video showing how a voice sounds with and without an isolation shield, and an example of how a pop filter works in our blog post dedicated to the topic. I will put a link to it in the description, so be sure to check it out. Step number 3. Install screen recording and video editing software. In addition to a microphone, you will need a recording tool. For the search term screencast software download, Google returns about 1,050,000 results. Among them are some reviews and developer sites where you can download the software. Step number 4. Prepare the room for recording. No matter how good a microphone is, it can't completely block ambient background noise. That's why you need to prepare before recording, and here are my 3 tips. First, choose a small room for recording, because in a large room, your voice will echo off the walls more loudly. Second, close the windows tightly. Turn off phones, computers, fans, and any other appliances. Make sure your chair doesn't squeak. And the third, the room shouldn't be empty, otherwise the sound will be hollow, as if you're sitting in the bathroom. If you plan to keep doing your own voiceovers and screencasts, slowly build up the acoustic treatment in your recording area. invest in something like a whisper room. If you don't have a dedicated recording space, put up heavy blankets, heavy curtains, anything you can to put mass between your recording space and the outside world. Here's the tip for you. Hang an on-air sign on the door so that colleagues or kids or both don't stumble into your session. Step number 5. Prepare your voice for recording. When recording a voiceover, you need to read the text in a light and convincing manner. It's difficult to do this if you are distracted, as you need to pronounce words correctly and decide which syllables to emphasize. So before recording, do some rehearsing. Read the script out loud several times. To ensure that your voice sounds good, do some vocal warm-ups. You will find a link to more tips in the description section. While recording, it's incredibly important to use the microphone properly. It shouldn't be too far from your mouth because it will pick up more ambient noise, nor should it be too close because it can pick up unwanted mouth sounds and max out the decibels. Also, make sure the volume is adjusted properly so the final effect is a nice, fat waveform with no signal clipping. Breathing naturally is essential as well. No one wants to listen to a robot, even if that robot has a beautiful voice. You want to sound like you are talking with someone or teaching someone. You aren't just reading words from a page. You are trying to make them come alive, even with training material. Here's another tip. Posture also affects the quality of recording, so keep your back straight. At the same time, the belly should be distended and the chest pulled forward. Correct posture will help your voice sound stronger and more expressive. The last step, step number 6, record the screencast. Here are some tips that will help you make a high-quality screencast. Before recording, remove unwanted objects from the shot. Nobody wants to see the toolbar with the start button if it's not going to be used. Turn off pop-ups and messenger notifications so you don't have to re-record the video after a message from your buddy pops up in the corner. Record screencasts at a high resolution. If you make resolution any smaller, the viewer won't be able to see what is happening on the screen clearly, and there will be black margins around the video after uploading it to YouTube. Take breaks. If you need to collect your thoughts or drink some water, take a break. Only first-class professionals can record a screencast on the first take. The key is high-quality content. Record voice and screen separately. This helps to avoid extra takes. For example, if you narrate a line incorrectly, you won't have to re-record what is happening on the screen. It's sufficient to read the complex paragraphs one more time and sync it with the video. Remove unwanted video scenes. The screencast should begin as soon as the viewer clicks on the start button. Dead air at the beginning and at the end of the lesson is a waste of time. Cut unwanted clips mercilessly. If you opt for iSpring Suite Max for screencasting, here's what you need to do to record a screencast. First, decide on the format of your video. iSpring allows you to create a screencast with narration or a screencast with a webcam video. Here's how. A screencast plus narration. After installing iSpring Suite on your computer, you will see an additional tab in PowerPoint. Click on Screen Recording. Then, in the Recording Settings window, choose the Screen tab. Make sure your microphone is on. Then specify the size of the recording area. This can be a portion of the screen, the entire screen, or the window of a specific application. As you record, there are a few things to keep in mind to create a clean-looking video. Hide your mouse cursor so it's not distracting to your viewer, or make sure the cursor is clear and visible if it's a part of the tutorial. Pause if you make a mistake, so when you edit, it'll be easier for you to find the places where you've made mistakes and cut them out. Speak clearly and with the tone and pace you have chosen for the video. If you're going to record a screencast and webcam video at the same time, choose the screen and camera option in the recording settings window. You can show both streams together or easily switch between them. After your recording is complete, you can edit it. Remove noise and unwanted video, glue video fragments together, and add video effects. Here are some tips and tricks that can help you make your screencasts even better looking and more engaging. To add more clarity to your screencast, complement it with other media. For example, you can add pictures, infographics, and different video footage. Another way to make things easier for viewers to understand and at the same time attract their attention to certain points is to create annotations, graphs, and captions. For instance, outline the steps of the process that you demonstrate on the screen. To direct your viewers' eyes where you want them to go, spotlight mouse actions. With tools like iSpring Suite, you can highlight a cursor and add click sounds. However, keep in mind that excessive mouse movements are distracting, so hide your mouse when it's not being moved. In order for your video to look professional, connect the segments with the transitions. The scenes should naturally flow from one to the next with no abrupt cuts. If you demonstrate an on-screen process without any voiceover instructions, add some music to set the mood of your video tutorial. To sum up, screencasting is a great solution that helps bridge the gaps for globally connected workforces, teachers, students, software developers, and customers. Making a screencast allows the person on the other end to hear your voice and provides important context to your words. It's not only effective, but also a simple instructional tool that you can jump into and start using right away. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up down below. And also click the red subscribe button to come join the iSpring community. We'd love to have you on board. And finally, hit the bell notification icon so you get notified every time we upload a brand new video. We share more tips on our blog, so go ahead and explore it. Take care and good luck with your screencasts. Bye!